Bismillahirrahmanirrahim. Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. Apa khabar anda di luar sana? How are you today? Okay, once again, sekali lagi anda bersama chef dalam platform chef, iaitu kitchen chef tadi, itu kitchen chef tadi. Kali ini saya akan berkongsi ilmu berkenaan dengan satu lagi resipi, iaitu kita akan membuat masakan topinang kan. Sama cumin powder, cumin powder kisar jintan putih buat 1 teaspoon, satu sudu kecil makan jintan putih, fennel seed powder, jintan manis dalam satu sudu makan kecil 1 teaspoon, turmeric powder, kunyit, serbuk kunyit, turmeric powder buat 2 teaspoon, 2 sudu makan kecil, chili powder about 3 teaspoon chili powder, dalam 3 sudu makan kecil. So everything we mix, the powder yang bahan campuran tu kita akan campur, kita akan masukkan dalam 200 ml air, we put mix with the together 200 ml milliliter water to make a paste, something like paste. Yeah, the same part 3, number 3 kita perlukan bahan untuk kita menghiris, bawang merah, serai, halia dan sedikit bawang putih dan 3 ulas. We need bombay onion, red onion, bombay, sama ginger, big ginger, 3 pieces of garlic, clean garlic and lemongrass, one numbers. Together with the curry leaf, we need curry leaf. Kita perlukan daun kari, about 2 stalk, about that 2, dalam 2 tangkai itulah. Daun kari. This curry leaf you can get in America. You can get this curry leaf in a grocery, Indian grocery. You can buy that curry leaf. This just mention curry leaf. Curry leaf. This one for the third step for the julienne. Step ketiga. Step keempat. We need tamarind juice. Air asam Jawa. Air asam Jawa lebih kurang dalam 70 gram. Air dalam 150 ml. This is a tamarind paste you can get in a Asian grocery. So tamarind paste, the quantity about 70 gram. So the water you mix with the water, something you teramas, something you pull like that, become a juice, tamarind juice. About water about 150 ml. So we need coconut milk, santan about 300 ml, coconut milk. This one everything is you can get in America or in other European country. You can get in a Asian grocery or Indian grocery, you can buy that as mentioned the name. Then with a bit alba campur, it's say something lah, penasi something lah. Kita panggil di sini, kita panggil halba campur lah. Sini saya pakai halba lah, campur dulu tak ada lah, saya pakai halba ya. So of course we need the oil. Kita perlukan minyak ah. Dah tentu kita perlukan minyak. Step number 4 is something like garnishing. Untuk hiasan lah, tomato, we need one number tomato, sebiji tomato. This one lady finger. Lady finger, if you don't know, you can see why the Indian grocery, Asian grocery, lady finger. Ini panggil mani lah, kita panggil mani. One red chili and one green chili. Satu cabai merah, satu cabai hijau, chili hijau jadi mani. And the last one is of course it's a salt. What's your salt? Garam lah, about 2 teaspoon. So saya dah terangkan bahan-bahan yang diperlukan. Here I already mentioned to you what the ingredients we need to make it this curry. Okay. garlic and one lemongrass. Kalau tak nak letak serai, tak perlu juga lah, tak terpulang pada anda lah. Together, campurkan semua bahan ke dalam. Then this one something like buat campur dia kot, kena sheet. Okay, now we heat the preheat the fire. Kita arah kacau arah lawan jam.
Bismillah, selawat 7 kali insyaAllah. Apa makanan yang kita buat tu, insyaAllah Allah pelihara, Allah berkatkan makanan kita jadi baik kan. So, di saute this one, yellow colour, anti-pegram. Ada tomat, tinggal kuningan, ada bimbingan di situ. Okay, inilah studio chef. Studio tak seberapa, tapi alhamdulillah lah chef dapat memberi sedikit input ilmu kepada adik-adik di luar sana. Ada ada yang bujang, kurang-kurangnya anda dapat belajar, dapat berniaga. Sama-sama zaman-zamannya, zaman gawat kita ni. Carilah apa yang kita boleh buat, insyaAllah. Kita cubalah, chef pun salah juga, problem juga ni. Kejap tak ada. Tawakal lah, kita usaha sama kita tawakal. See that? The color is already done. You can see the color has turned yellow. So now I can put the mixture of spice. You need to cook until the broken oil, something like oil coming up. So that means it's a process. You kill the powder. Anda kena masak sehingga dipanggil pecah minyak lah, baru dia punya rempah tu akan pecah. Begini lah macam mana hotel, restoran buat kan begini. Mamak kita nak buat, tapi ibu kita masakan sedap lagi lah kan. Di situ kita nampak ya. Tomat, untuk pecah minyak, you cook it until the broken oil. This called broken oil ni, the oil will come on top the layer on the spice. You can see that. Agak pecah minyak lah, panggil pecah minyak. Ada di luar sana, ada di chef, ada culinary, ada tak pergi ilmu ni. Budak-budak bujang kan boleh masak kan. Masak, makan dengan kawan-kawan. Bagi yang baru-baru kahwin kan, baguslah. Ajar bagi kat kami, ajar. Jangan tak tahu langsung kan, kena ambil tahu juga lah. Tapi makanan tu sedap, masak untuk suami, sedap. Suami pun tak cari nak hilang kan. Kena jaga hati suami kan. Dia penat-penat bekerja, luar bekerja kan. Dia buat isteri ni kena jaga lah. Ini kan penat bekerja di luar. Balik-balik makanan tersedia, alhamdulillah. Okay, sekarang kita makan luar kan. Bawa nak makan luar. Kalau bagi mamak ni, dia tak pakai santan. Memang tak pakai santan. Dia pakai air asam, air asam Jawa. Lepas tu dia boleh simpan. Dia depan naga, dia simpan semua, dia masuk dalam peti sejuk. Peti beku. Esok dia keluar, dia panaskan saja balik. Sebab tu kadang-kadang dah 2-3 hari, kita tak perasan. Itu style dia. Style India lah, panggil style India. Kita orang Melayu ni, orang sekilah kan. Boleh kita nak buat macam mamak, tak ada masalah. Sebab tak ada alat kedah. Buka apa sudah. You can see there, the oil is coming. On top, we call broken oil. See, you can see oil. Listen, on top, oil. This is broken oil. Nampak situ? Ini panggil pecah minyak. Macam ni panggil pecah minyak. Dia lama sikit-sikit saja. Sikit lagi. Pecah minyak. Lalu kita masukkan asam jawa. Santan. After the coconut oil, you put the tamarind juice and coconut milk. Okay, you put tamarind juice. Now you put coconut milk. 300 ml. You need, kalau anda nak kuah lebih, masukkan air sedikit lagi lah. Dia akan masak. Dia akan berlegak. Let the boiling first. Then after that, you put the fish and the rest. The last one is put the salt. This is my kitchen, my studio kitchen. You can see it's a small studio kitchen. So this studio, I'm create my own studio to teach the young generation, to give them some info. At least they know something. Bagi sedikit info kepada adik-adik di negeri sana ataupun anda-anda di luar. Kitchen yang tak seberapa ni. Ya, alhamdulillah lah. Saya dapat mengumpul bahan-bahan saya beli di Amerika, equipment, utensil dan beli di Malaysia juga. Saya berkumpul, saya dapat membina sesuatu small studio kitchen. This one some of the item I buy in America. When I been in America, in Washington and California also. I been in California to 1 year, in San Francisco 1 year, in Seattle, Washington 2 years. So I've been there in I doing Asian cuisine, like Malaysian typical food, some Malaysian, some Indonesian and Thai a bit, Singapore a bit Brunei, so Asian cuisine. So I cook in there. So at the same time also I make something like Malaysian dessert, something like kuih. We call kuih Melayu, we call Malaysian sweet dessert, traditional style. So this at the night I doing part time. I doing Asian, I doing Western, I'm learning about Western, I'm learning about French cuisine at the night time. In the morning, breakfast morning, I do the Asian. Now I be back in my country, I do some like lecturing, like lecturer. This is a young generation. Okay, nampak di situ. Kita agak masukkan ikan yang telah kita basuh. Kita persiang, kita basuh dengan sedikit garam dan air asam jawa. So cuci. This is fish. You clean first. You put some salt and tamarind. Mix together. All everything mix together, stir mix together, then you clean back with the butter. When you want to throw the smell of the fish, masukkan ikan. Ni saya masuk 4 ke 5 ya. Saya nak katakan kuah, lebihan kuah. Then now you can put the
lady finger boleh masukkan.
Ili tomato boleh masukkan.
So, ni kepu some onion also. Some fallen onion, whatever you can throw inside.
Onion also. So, and don't forget salt. I put here about 2 teaspoon. If feel like I not taste, put a little bit more. Kalau anda rasa tak cukup rasa, tambah sedikit.
Fish curry. Chef Zaidi style. Kalau anda nak lebihkan lebihan kuah, masukkan sedikit bagi air ataupun santan kepada anda. If you want to bit more sauce, you put some coconut milk or water.
Fish curry need a bit, not too salt, salty, not too salty, salty, sour, something taste sour and spicy. Macam ikan curry, curry ikan ni kita nak rasa dia dah macam ada masin sedikit, tak masin sangat kan, jangan terlalu masin. Dan sedikit masam dan sedikit pedas. Betul, curry ikan. It's a Penang style curry, fish curry. My guess is it's normal. You can put some bit water. Boleh tambah sikit air kalau anda suka. Saya nak masukkan lebih kuah. You want to buat nak ada rasa kuah tu lebih sikit. Make sure the fish is cooked or done. Huh? You can see there, fish there. The fish is cooked, so everything done.
So you blow the fire a little bit. Within the fire.
Kecil ke api, ya? Kita kecilkan api. Okay, almost done. Make sure the fish and the lady finger is cooked. Should be okay. Okay, now it's done. Fish curry we share dari ya. Okay, sekarang dah siap. Kari ikan Pulau Pinang. Campur utara sikit lah, campur Kedah sikit lah. Kari ikan Pulau Pinang daripada chef. Kalau mamak, biasa mamak punya kari ikan dia tak pakai santan. Kalau tanya kenapa chef, tak pakai kari mamak ni tak pakai santan. Memang begitu, mamak tak pakai santan sebab dia nak save cost. Macam kami ni, orang Pulau Pinang ni ada mami-mami sikit lah. Lebih kurang mami sikit kami pakai santan. Ni ibu chef ada. This is my mother taste. My mother teach me how to make. Okay. Kita akan berjumpa lagi dalam next episode dan resipi yang lain-lain lagi sama chef. InsyaAllah jangan lupa subscribe YouTube chef. Support chef juga. Saya akan bagi lagi ilmu-ilmu. Masakan Melayu, masakan Cina, masakan India, masakan Barat. Dan formula-formula tentang teori yang praktikal saya akan terangkan kepada anda. Saya akan guide anda lah, insyaAllah. So, don't forget. See my YouTube, Kitchen Chef Zahri. Subscribe and like. And so, share with other people. So, the main same time also, I will give some idea menu from Chinese time. Menu, Indian menu. Some Western. Some formula, some teori yang praktikal. For you all, outside there. Okay. InsyaAllah. Harap kita berjumpa lagi. Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. Harios amigos. Como está?